Welcome back to Champions of the Parish. I'm Dang Square.
I'm Jake Wapo.
And we're going to bring you another Commander EDH 1v1. But this one's going to be a little special because we're doing a mirror match. Aloro versus Thanos, a.k.a. Aloro.
This is going to be a lot of life gain.
A lot of life gain. This might be a long haul. So get your popcorn and get ready because it's going to be fun.
I believe I'm going to roll.
You want to roll.
I'm going to roll.
So,
start off with a evolving balls. Pass my turn.
I will pop it. Snap, crunch, pop. Alright, I go off the turn. That's actually really impressive.
All of the good.
I play Temple of Silence, scry one. I'm going to shoot that. Not ready, we're failing.
Yep. Sorry, my bad.
Life game. Actually,
that's very good. In my defense, I haven't played Aloro in quite a while.
Aloro!
This used to be my really competitive deck.
Yeah, but then you got Slivers.
Then Slivers happened, yeah.
This was my actual first EDH deck that I've ever had that I had from the pre-con and built up to what it is now. That's a pretty decent deck, too. Very optimized.
My first one was Naya, then Aloro, and then Slivers, and then the Slivers just keep consuming your soul, and...
Yep. So yeah, I'm off coming down.
It's fine.
Alright, go ahead. Gotta hear what they are. I can't really see them.
So, those can draw for turn.
Life game two,
thank you.
Also, while I'm thinking about it, shout out to Atomic Ashes again for a great Thanos proxy. I'll probably have the actual picture of the card over here, but it's a really cool proxy. Check them out on Instagram.
Azorius Sanctuary, Bounce Land, bouncing my white man to my hand, comes to battle attack. That's my turn.
Untap, game two. Draw a turn. Card. I'm going to go ahead and play a Reliquary Tower. Hand size is not matter. I'm going to go ahead and tap white and one and play Oresco's Sun Guide. Landfall, whatever. Sun Guide comes on tap, gain two life. Pass turn, go.
Play a swamp.
That's okay.
Untap. Draw a card. So I'm gonna play Island. So I have to turn. Play white, blue, or excuse me, white one. White and two with the blue. And play Azorius Herald. Can't be blocked. I gain four life. Four. And enter the battlefield sacrifice unless blue is spent to cast it, which I did say in the movie. Then I'm gonna go ahead and swing two.
Ouch.
Turn. Negates all damage.
Who you got? God, that's fine.
Who you got? Oh, who you got?
Yep. In the last thorough set.
Not a creature.
Not a creature. Fast turn. He is, however, is indestructible.
Yep. Untap. Gain two life. Gain two life. Draw for turn. We're going to go ahead and do white and two. I will play Teo, the Shield Mage. That's five. I have Hexproof. I will going to play Land for Turn, bouncing my Temple of Silence back to me. And the ability is a minus two, create a 0/1 white wall creature token with Defender. which I have. Yeah, I found that I had a 2-2 spirit token the other day. I guess I was like, oh, I could use you a lot, right? And then, go ahead and swing for 4.
Okay.
Turn.
Shambling vent. Ability in putting a 2-1 white cleric enchantment creature token into the battlefield. You have to enchant the fire.
Boom.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Oh.
Okay. Alright. And. Is there a No. Yeah. Okay. Can't walk. Turn.
Okay, untap turn. Untap. Gain 2 from that. Gain 2 from Laura. Draw for turn. I'm gonna go ahead and just knock him down 2 into the wall. Create 0 wall, 3-0-3 wall with defender. And then swing 4. 2-1 and 2-2. Nope. They die. Okay, 2. Last turn.
Okay. Get that more. I'm going to... That's the turn.
Alright. Only game 2 this time. Draw off turn. I'm gonna go ahead and play Temple of Silence. Slide. Put that on bottom. I'm gonna go ahead and play Black Blue. Play Limdahl's Bolt. This may take a minute. Look at top 5 cards of your library. As many times you choose, you may pay 1 life. Put those cards on the bottom of the library in any order you like. Or any order, then look at the top 5 cards of your library. Then shuffle the library and put the last 5 cards you looked at in any way you want. So, first time. I can't count how many times we do this. Yeah. Hopefully it won't take too many times. 4, 5. Alright, so we're gonna do that one time. Cause I like what we had. So it's not gonna be that long of an edit. You're welcome, future me. Alright. Did I play land for turn? I think we can play that. Then I'm gonna go ahead and swing 2.
Is it unblockable or anything?
It's unblockable.
Is it?
Yeah, it can't be blocked.
Uh-huh.
Turn.
Play Ellen of Rhetoric.
Yep.
Each player can't cast more than 1 spell each turn.
Okay. Edolon
of... Edolon of Rhetoric.
Yeah, yep. That sounds about right.
Cool. And I will play the Mortuary Admirer for my man this turn. I don't have any creatures in my graveyard, so I can't use its ability. Grass for 1. You have 1 damage to that, and I'm gonna gain 1 life.
Okay.
And I will pass
Okay. Two. Untap. Draw for turn. White, black, white. One. Play Obzedud, Ghost Council. Enter the battlefield, target opponent loses 2 life, I gain 2 life. At the beginning of end step, you may exile Obzedud. If you do, return to the battlefield under its owner's control. At the beginning of the next upkeep, it gains haste. It's a 5-5. And since I can't play nothing else, go.
Towards Isle Refuge.
Nice.
Oop, nice.
Oh, yeah, no. My bad.
Come back from your upkeep?
Yeah, the beginning of my upkeep. Yeah.
Or next upkeep, so my upkeep.
The beginning of your next upkeep.
You do it every turn?
Yeah. At the beginning of your end step, you may exile as a mage.
Oh,
I don't have to, but
gotcha.
He pretty much is bouncing himself.
More or less, yeah. Okay. Creating another fire.
Alright.
And I will swing with one cleric and
this dude.
I'm taking three.
Taking three.
Okay, I'll block your one cleric and I'll take one.
Okay. That's your turn.
Alright. And two, he enters in the battlefield. You lose two, I gain two. Alright, and I go off for turn. He gains haste. We're gonna head and play another Isle of Turn. I'm gonna tap three for crawl space. No more than two creatures can attack me each combat. I'm gonna minus him to one. And create another wall. Right. Two walls. I'll go ahead and end step, exile him out.
Wait, before your end step, appraisal to destroy target creature, fire, or greater. After your generator.
Okay, he goes to their step.
Appraisal.
Good. Alright.
Zoras, Hellard.
Use the blue two. Cast him.
So, four.
Two. Forgot to do it.
Alright, that's...
Well, a lot of these cards look familiar.
Okay, so...
All three. Because it's not directed at you, so
right.
Crawl space is negated. Four.
This is through. Wording. Okay, so either way I block,
he dies. He does.
So it doesn't matter how I block it.
Don't have to block it at all.
I don't know, because I can block those two.
He's also going to hit.
So you're not going to block?
Nothing's going through with you.
So I choose not to block this first time.
That's turn. Knife hand.
Alright. Okay, 2 life. Untapped. Off for turn. Okay. Tap blue, three. Tap an artifact. And I'm gonna play Zahid, Djinn of the Lamp.
Okay.
And fly is 5/6.
Nice.
Go ahead.
Playing Neil Spellbomb.
Playing Dark Steel Mutilation. Melee 0/1 bug. Sorry.
Indestructible though.
It is indestructible.
I don't like talking about
it. It's only.
Dark Skin.
Tap, sacrifice my spell bomb for you to sell your graveyard. And you play. Tap Swamp to draw a card. Two of these do
four.
So you have four creatures coming at you.
Okay.
One's unblocked.
Okay, so I'll block the others.
Yeah.
And I'll take two. Yeah, I'm actually gonna.
Never mind that.
And I'll take two.
Take two. Haha, no more 69. Back turn.
Haha.
Back to 69. Okay, I've done that anyway. Miss play.
Oh, yeah, so
box.
I'll let it go.
I'll let you have it. It's fine. Miss play. You would have got the block in it. Well, no, you still would have taken the two.
I would take the look. Yeah, we'll have to take it now.
Yeah. Yeah, because he's unblockable. Anyway. Yes.
It resolves.
Resolves. It's okay. Misplay, but also resolve.
And that would count where you're at, right?
Yeah. Do the casting. Thanos out of the chair.
Thanos out of the chair. Like him and Dogma have a lot of combat, other than fighting as for 6. But
there's the reason why he only stays in his chair.
Brings good out of his chair. But well, I can't attack with anything, so go ahead. I can't play nothing else.
Beginning of each upkeep, I have a tap or untap target permanent.
Two. Okay. Beginning of my turn, I gain two, and in response to gain two, paying one.
Yep.
Drawing a card, you lose a life, and then I tap.
And on your upkeep as well.
Happen.
I will tap him down.
After that. In response. That's his tap. Yep, yeah, okay, I probably should use damage to the card. I'm gonna put 1,000 lashes on him.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and play last turn.
I can't use his ability at all. It's good.
Pretty much. He's just there.
And I'll lose life for him being there.
Okay. Go ahead.
So I gain one life.
Yep.
Okay. Lamp turn. Playing faded in infatuation, making a copy of him. And because it's my turn, I next card too. I can never freaking pronounce that right. About the cut.
Yeah. And here's the special to the tag.
Well, it'll
be a very good thing. One of my many four ones. Go ahead, come on.
Okay. Some tab. Card. Ooh, I didn't know that was what I was getting. Divinity of Pride.
This card. 8-8.
He is a 8-8, and guess who else is online now? Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yep.
Now he needed.
Five. I just needed him back. Yeah, version 5 or what?
Okay, because he's a token copy. He's not an actual copy.
Well, he's all blue.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That by itself, yeah, puts him online. So yeah.
Okay. Not yet. So I'm gonna take this. Really odd, and I'm Zoris.
Block him with camera, I think.
Yep.
Thank you. And that's the turn. Okay, I banged you live. Yep, you say, oh, you say that tap?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Tap that first ability, you lose one, I draw a card. Untap, you draw for turn. I think I've done it twice where I forgot to draw for turn. I'm supposed to draw two cards, but later.
I don't think I gained life last turn, but it's fine.
Well, I mean, I kind of gave you that.
Fine.
It's fine.
It's fine,
man. Let's do this. This is nice. Actually, I don't need two, three, white, one. Ball Council of Allocation. Whenever an opponent casts a non-creature spell, that player loses 2 life, and I gain 2 life.
Okay.
Yeah. Good. Balance is about to shift.
Does he have vigilance?
Yeah, everybody has vigilance.
Other creatures you control have vigilance.
Oh, he doesn't. Sorry. So, that's fine.
Sounds stupid.
And all creatures have vigilance, but.
Other creatures you control have vigilance. I guess because technically you're not a creature until you kill them all in.
Yeah.
Pull from the deep, return up to one target, instant target, up to one target sorcery card from a graveyard to my hand.
Resplendent Angel.
And what else?
Flying at the beginning of your end step, if you gain 5 life or more this turn, create a 4/4 white angel creature token with flying and vigilance. 3 white until end of turn, resplendent angel is +2/+2 and gains life flying.
Cool.
There's 8 from that.
That's turn.
Game two.
Lose one. Keep your disc tap down and your change it back.
Okay. Resolve one. Draw that. Resolve turn. As well as untap turn. Land for turn. Tap one and white giant pride man. Go ahead.
Get one tap. Each of
them. Oh, each one.
Okay, so what?
Let's do
tapping.
Take 2 damage.
Okay, the attack is still game.
It doesn't matter. I'm just tapping it.
Okay. So I will end up. So turn.
Yep. I can't go.
Alright. Gain 2 lives. And tap that. If you lose one, I draw a card. Untap.
And your this and angel. Tap down.
This right. Angel tap down. And I draw for turn. Alright, now do this.
Johnny Trigger.
Huh?
The Johnny Trigger.
Oh yes, he does get a trigger.
That's true. Is it one or two?
You only gets one.
Yeah, but you gain it,
anytime you gain life.
Gains life, you
gain. That's gaining two is one time.
Right.
So that's one. I'm not fighting it. So it's 3-3. Alright. White, black, 1, 2, three, four. Gonna play Death's Grasp on him, kill him. I gain 4, X is 4. Now that that's gone, and I'll keep on that. So that's 4, 6, so he'll trigger at the end of turn. We're gonna go ahead and go to black, blue. I'm gonna play Baleful Strix, draw a card, Flying Death Touch. I can't do nothing else. Go ahead, end step, and I'll get an angel. From a Splendid Angel for gaining 6 life. And
okay.
I'm gonna keep tap down.
Tap down. Tap down.
Tap.
Avison, Angel of Hope.
Yeah, double vision.
And everything's indestructible. All the permanents you control are indestructible.
Okay.
Her and everything.
Yep. serve immortality.
Oh, I'm sorry, I have a block there. A block thing. I'm going to go around these two.
Okay, that's okay. You're still getting eight,
but I'll go up eight.
Combos in this deck?
I do, yes. Yeah. I do too, but I don't remember if I have the other half of it in here.
I do. Okay. My beer hat.
Huh?
I'm untapping.
Oh, yes. Staff.
Yeah, I could just like totally screw you up.
And.
Drop a turn. That black white. Cruel celebrant. Whenever she dies or another creature or a planeswalker you control dies, aristocrat, you can do like I got
one. Okay.
And one, two, three for talisman. Christine the Talisman.
Yep.
And then, and then black, one trigger on the stack. Two, three, four. That's actually pretty perfect. Exquisite blood.
Nice.
Whenever an opponent loses life, I gain life. And with that on the stack, the life gain on the stack, tap one, you lose one. I draw a card, and I also gain one from exquisite blood. And if I had more, I could continue the cycle, but I'm out of mana. So yeah, I got that going for me. Alright, now I've gained 3 life this turn, so she will not trigger. Nothing died. This goes to 4. Mm-hmm. One, twice. Go ahead.
Okay, Smokey. Death. And death. Game 1.
Mortify. Destroy target creature or enchantment.
Yep. Sure it's playing like that one?
Yeah. I'll mind that one right now.
You're gonna be getting two other ones.
That is not my problem at the moment.
Yeah, the next round is about to be hurting.
Yeah!
I mean, it was gonna take a minute to figure out how it was gonna start it because I wasn't able to start on the back and tapped out. But once I looked in Hizzy for one, it was gonna be a... Yeah. Be casting effect.
Vermaz, King of Berserkers, or Orso Kill. Whatever. Vermaz. Kitty King. Fucking Cat King right there, man.
Johnny's Primate.
Hey. That's nice.
Right?
That's cool. That's good. And I'm going to pay two. Tap. Gain five life. During season, Florida's ability. You take one life and I will draw a card. And all this goes into my library. Shuffle.
Very good. Again.
No problem.
Pass turn. Gain two life. Can't use your effect. Untap.
Okay. So, on your upkeep, I will tap down both of them.
Off the turn. Go ahead and play land for turn. I'm going to play this. Three black. And then three black. And one, two, three. Oh, this is Citadel. Look at the top card of your library at any time. You may play the top card of the library if you cast this. Spell this way, pay life equal to the CMC rather than pay its mana cost. Pay one, full ring.
Nice.
He ain't paying that much though. Alright. So that was pretty cool. But what I will do, pay three. Ooh, actually. Hold on. This should have been the first thing I did. Let's go ahead and do this, because fuck it. I'm going to tap this, sack it. Oh, I'm sorry. Tap that, sack 10 permanents. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Each opponent loses 10 life. So you lose 10 life. Pay one, gain a life, tap that, destroy everything.
Okay.
Yeah, them shark percentage is still there. Scoop! Hey. Bye!
Come on.
That's game. I forgot that.
Has in the shirt.
I thought I fucking forgot about that.
So it makes you feel better. I was gonna play Platinum Angel next turn. Yeah,
that's game. Bye. He wins. Bye. Bye bye.
This was Aloro versus Aloro.
So- God.